What's up, YouTube? This is Winter's Camp. I'm Nick. Today, I'm going to review the London Bridge Trading 1749B kit. Stick around, this is going to be a good one.
If you're a backpacker or an outdoorsman or even someone from the military, you know that when you hear the words London Bridge Trading, the first thing that comes to mind is quality. And let me tell you, London Bridge makes really, really good backpacks. And they make a lot of good military gear. First things first, a lot of people don't know how to handle a rucksack this size. It's awkward to put them on because you can load them up to almost 100 pounds. I got roughly 50 pounds in this one. Let me show you how to put one of these on. First, start out with the pack directly in front of you, lying on its face with the drag handle pointing towards you. Now, since I have an Atlas frame, we're able to grab it by the frame itself and grab it like this, like so. Lift it up over your head like this. Now, you don't have to worry about your carrying straps rolling up under your shoulders when you go to put it on. And that was 50 pounds. And there you see how easy that was to put on. Now this pack has 10 pockets. And I'll show you them all. Two very large side pockets here. Believe it or not, I have a tent in this one. This one over here, I have the Camelback hydration bladder and a carrier. It all fits in here. Now, since it is two zippers, I have carabinered them together to limit the chances of these zippers coming undone. With all zippered backpacks that have dual zippers, I would highly recommend using carabiners for zipper locks. These two medium-sized front pouches. I can carry a titanium mug in here. This other pouch above it is the same as the bottom one, same exact size. I can keep a canvas bag with a fire starting kit in this one. Now these ones on the left and to the right of these two center pouches are exactly the same size. Like I said, I can keep canvas pouches full of various items for various needs. And they have quick disconnect buckles so that when you are about rucking, you can keep them snapped together and keep your zippers from coming undone, and that would eliminate some carabiners also. Same exact thing over here on this side, very exact same thing. Same size pouches, buckles, secure the zippers. And so roughly 8 pockets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And your 9 and 10 pockets are gonna be here on your lid. I love this clamshell pocket here because it opens up quite a bit. This very bottom pocket here. Not very big, but I'm able to put another utility pouch in this one. I believe this clamshell pocket opens to 300 degrees, so it opens up quite a bit. And there's another top pouch here, so this makes pocket number 10. I have a handsaw, a pair of gloves, and my sleeping pad, my inflatable sleeping pad. This pack is very versatile and it can accommodate for very many things. Backpacking, camping, hiking, multiple day hiking, you name it. This thing has it all. and I was very lucky to find this backpack at an Army surplus store for around $125. This kit alone from London Bridge Trading runs around $800. That is a lot of money for a pack. I would probably never spend that much on a pack. But lucky for me, I found this at the Army surplus store local to me for around $125. However, it did not come with a suspension kit that London Bridge also makes. I had just bought this recently. And this suspension kit is the LBT2168E. Like I said, with the suspension system and the pack, all the kit is over $800. I was lucky to find this suspension system kit on eBay for around $80. This is brand new. Very thick padding, very comfortable. However, you do not need this kit from London Bridge to make this pack complete. You can use Molly 2 straps on these Alice packs. That's a whole nother separate modification for Alice frames. And I often hear it called the Hellcat mod. So you can adapt Molly 2 shoulder straps and the waist strap to an Alice frame. I will post links to my channel so you all can see what I'm talking about. And to put this suspension kit on, I will also put a link in my YouTube to show you how London Bridge puts this suspension system on the Alice frame. It is a very good, thorough video, and that's how I learned how to put this on. It's really, really simple. The other thing about the suspension system is it has, I think they're lumbar support, according to London Bridge, but I've also heard people say that they're additional hydration pouches, and there are two of them, one on each side. So interesting enough that if you could fit hydration bladders in here, you could fit two more large hydration bladders in these side pockets, and you could ruck all day probably, stay hydrated. So that's a cool feature. I like that. The top lid is held together by these two quick disconnect buckles here. The very top part of the bag has a drawstring enclosure. You can carry multiple items in here. I got a tarp, an extra pair of pants, shirt, schmog, jacket. The main compartment has a divider so that you can divide the top and bottom compartments. In the bottom compartment, you can put a sleeping bag in here. Also, you can fit the modular sleep system in this compartment. You would probably have to load it very first thing before you start putting stuff in the top compartment. If you want to use the modular sleep system, load that first, then load your contents on top. Inside the main compartment, there is another compartment that is cinched down with a Fastex buckle. Keep an iPad in here. You could probably put a hydration bladder in here also. And with that being said, if you happen to put a hydration bladder in here, there are three ports on top that are Velcroed together. These are ports for antenna or hydration bladder. Now, after you have the pack on your back, bend over with it. Get all the weight off the straps and find your cinch down buckles here. And cinch it down really good. Cinch it down tight. Find your waist buckle.
attach your waist buckle, find your chest strap, cinch it down, make it tight. There you go. All of your weight now is on your hips. And even though I got 50 pounds in here, it doesn't feel like it. I feel like I could load this thing up with 65 to 70 pounds and still be pretty comfortable. The only thing I don't like about the pack is the quick release buckles are kind of hard to get to. So if you want to uncinch this, you kind of got to give it some force to loosen these up. But I think the more I use it, the more I'll get used to it. Your straps do come with keepers, and they are sewn on with Velcro. So you just simply roll them up and use the Velcro to cinch them down and keep them out of the way. They do come with quick release buckles for quick detach, but you'll have to feed this bottom part through this strap here, and that could be a little bit of a task if you're not sitting down and getting the weight off your pack first. Also, another feature I like is if your quick disconnect buckles happen to break or malfunction, you can weave them through here on these old school Alice buckles here. And I like that feature. It seems like anything that you buy military has a backup plan, and that's a cool feature that I like. Another feature I like is the waist buckles. They have sewn the end of the buckle to like a butterfly so that it will not come out of the keeper. If you're out walking around, it will stay secure and not be flopping about. And that's a cool feature to have. Anytime that you can get all these straps nice and neat, to me that's a good feature because I don't like the straps flopping around. This pack features 3 covered ports for hydration and communication equipment, 10 double zippered pockets with paracord pull tabs, Alice frame enhancement suspension system, also known as the LBT2168E, load leveling adjustment straps, shoulder straps that allow adjustment in width for various neck and shoulder sizes, dual sleeves for 100 ounce 3 liter hydration bladders. The larger pocket has a 300 degree zipper, which allows for clamshell style opening. The main compartment has top and bottom access, lightweight shroud for securing contents. Overall dimensions are 30 inches long by 20 inches wide by 23 inches high. The weight of this pack is 10 pounds. The overall capacity is 5,075 cubic inches. Another thing, I do not know if they make this harness in Woodland or not. However, the green on this harness and the green on the Woodland matches pretty close. It's not to a T, but it's close. Just thought I'd throw that in there. The pros of this pack is the size and the capacity. I love the fact that it's 5,000 plus cubic inches. I also like having multiple pockets for various items. And I also like the suspension kit. It's been the most comfortable pack I've ever owned by far. The cons of this pack are the price and also the drawstring enclosure for the main pack could be a little bit longer. That way you could overstuff the pack. But those are the only things that I can think of. Would I spend retail price for this pack? Absolutely not. Would I buy another one? Yeah, I wouldn't think I'd have to buy another one because London Bridge Trading stands behind lifetime warranty. I would say if this thing starts to fall apart, they would probably replace it. Or if you find any kind of defects that you think didn't contribute to wear and tear, they would probably replace it for free. So, I hope you enjoyed this review of the 1749B kit by London Bridge Trading. In the meantime, keep hiking, keep moving, keep discovering, go camping, get on your canoe, go fishing, be in good spirits, and be in good health.